And here's another blow to commuters. The Light Rail Transit Authority rules out extending its free ride service to students. ABS-CBN correspondent Pia Gutierrez is on the line to tell us why. Go ahead, Pia.
Yes, Denise, despite strong public clamor, the Light Rail Transit Authority says it could no longer extend its free ride service to students, which ended last November 5. LRTA Administrator Hernando Cabrera, in a televised briefing, noted that the implementation of free ride service to students was only planned for the first quarter of the school year. He also says that extending the free ride service would negatively hit the LRT financially and will affect their budget for the maintenance, rehabilitation, and upgrading of the LRT's facilities. From August 22 to November 5, Cabrera says the LRT has been able to give as many as 1.6 million free rides to students. He adds that students are still entitled to a 20% fare discount and that they only need to present their valid school ID or proof of enrollment to avail of reduced LRT fare. Denise?
Thanks, Pia. One of the Philippines' major rail lines is not for sale. The Transportation Department clarifies it is only considering the possibility of turning over the operations and maintenance of the MRT-3 to private sector operators. This as it seeks to improve the railway's operational efficiency. Transport Secretary Jaime Bautista notes the deal would be similar to the one used for LRT-1, where the rail line's assets remained government-owned. The clarification comes after commuter group The Passenger Forum opposed plans to privatize the MRT-3. The group said the move will only lead to fare hikes without necessarily improving mass transport services. Commuters will have one less transportation option after the Philippine National Railways announces it will have limited operations. However, trains that will be running will be operating at reduced speeds. The state-run railway says it is conducting repairs on several train sets and clearing debris on some portions of its train tracks affected by the onslaught of Typhoon Paeng. The firm says it expects normal operations to resume after 2 to 3 weeks. Despite its limited trips, the PNR is still serving some 60,000 passengers daily. Netflix and other foreign digital services may soon be slapped with a 12% value-added tax, or VAT. That's after House lawmakers approved the measure on second reading Tuesday. Apart from generating more revenue for the government, the bill also seeks to level the playing field between traditional and digital businesses. But an entertainment and media law expert points out, it's the consumer who will be affected by this.
Ang essence ng VAT, wag nating kalimutan, it is a pass-on tax. Okay? So, in other words, you are taxing, let's say, Netflix or Prime Video or yung parating dito, Disney Plus. Okay? November 17 raw. Pag yan ay tinax nyo, ultimately, ipapass on yan
to the consumer.
To the consumer. If we impose the tax and it will be, there is also cost of regulation ipapasa rin sa ating mga kababayan yon. Why don't we work on collection and then we study this first?
Farm output in the Philippines grew 1.8% in the third quarter. This snaps two straight quarters of contraction for the sector. The data comes as government is set to release the third quarter GDP report on Thursday. Ahead of that report, Philippine economic growth in the second quarter was revised upward from 7.4% to 7.5%.